Wind shear. Terrain.
Warning, you heard right now are of GPWS. Hello everyone, welcome you all to the YouTube channel Little About Aviation. In this video, we will be talking about Ground Proximity Warning System, or also known as GPWS. Today, we will be talking about modes of operation of GPWS, indication associated with GPWS, and crash related to GPWS. Stay tuned with us throughout the video. As name only suggests, purpose of using GPWS is to warn flight crew regarding potential hazardous situation such as collision with terrain. GPWS was first introduced in 1970 as Terrain Awareness and Warning System, or TAWS. Prior to its introduction, there were 3 to 4 controlled flights into terrain event every year, killing hundreds of people. GPWS has height operating limit between 50 to 2450 feet height above surface or land. It uses radio altimeter for measuring altitude. There are 7 modes of operation of GPWS. Now, let us look at individual modes of operation of GPWS. Mode 1 provides protection against excessive barometric descent rate, and it is independent of aircraft configuration. There are 2 boundaries in Mode 1 GPWS. When the aircraft reaches first boundary, it generates an oral alert.
Sink rate.
Penetration into second boundary generates an oral as well as visual alert.
Oh, fuck.
The warning goes on until rate of descent has been corrected. Mode 2 GPWS provide protection against potential terrain. It has input from radio altitude rate of change, barometric altitude, Mach number, and aircraft configuration. According to the change in radio altimeter reading, aircraft identify potential terrain ahead. This system also has 2 boundaries. Crossing first boundary gives oral warning.
Terrain.
But it is so small that instantaneously it is followed by visual and audible warning.
Terrain ahead, pull up. Obstacle ahead, pull up.
If the aircraft poses threat in landing configuration, then only oral warning will be given.
Terrain.
Mode 3 of GPWS provide an alert if descent is made at initial climb or go around. It is effective between 50 to 700 feet radio altitude and generate alert when aircraft has descended 10% of existing altitude.
Don't sink.
The oral alert will be given until flight condition will not be corrected. Mode 4A of GPWS provide protection against terrain clearance when landing gear is not lowered. When the aircraft descend below 500 feet radio altitude and is at speed below 220 knots, then oral alert is heard.
Too low, gear.
With increase of speed above 220 knots, the boundary altitude is increased to 1000 feet and oral warning is changed.
Too low, terrain.
Mode 4B of GPWS is activated when landing gear is down, but flaps are not extended for landing. Then, at radio altitude below 250 feet and at speed less than 190 knots, oral alert as well as visual alert is given.
Minimum. Too low. Flaps. Too low. Flaps.
If aircraft speed is above 190 knots, then height range is increased to 1000 feet and warning changes.
Too low. Terrain. Too low. Terrain.
In both condition, repeated warning is given until condition is not converted. Mode 5 of GPWS is issued when aircraft descend more than 1.3 knots below glide slope. It is activated when valid ILS signal is received by Captain Glide Slope Receiver and radio altitude is below 1000 feet. It provides an oral warning with visual indication of below glide slope.
Glide slope. Glide slope.
Mode 6A of GPWS provide warning when the aircraft descend below minimum decision height. The minimum decision height is calculated according to airport condition. Minimum decision height is selected in non-precision approach or circling approach.
Minimum.
Pilots are allowed to descend below minimum decision altitude only if they have visual reference with runway, or else they are instructed to conduct go around. This warning system is activated after aircraft is below 1000 feet radio altitude. It provides an oral warning.
Minimum.
Mode 6B of GPWS provide radio altitude call out.
50, 40, 30, 20, retard, retard.
And provide bank angle alert.
Bank angle. Bank angle.
Bank angle warning is made when aircraft has excessive rolling rate. Excessive rolling rate may result in wings losing lift and might bring aircraft into a dangerous stall. Mode 7 of GPWS provide visual and oral alert when aircraft enters a potential wind shear or microburst area.
Wind shear, wind shear, wind shear.
Wind shear ahead, wind shear ahead.
It uses data from ground speed, air speed, barometric height, rate of descent, and radio altitude to identify potential wind shear or microburst area. A detailed video regarding microburst or wind shear will be made in upcoming videos. This mode of GPWS allows crew to recognize wind shear faster, which increases their chance of escaping. It provides oral warning when aircraft approaches near microburst and give oral as well as visual warning when aircraft enter inside microburst.
Wind shear, wind shear, wind shear.
Wind shear ahead, wind shear ahead. Go around, wind shear ahead.
Now, let us talk about enhanced GPWS or EGPWS. The reason behind introduction of EGPWS was GPWS was not able to identify terrain ahead properly, especially if it is steep terrain. So EGPWS was introduced. It uses World Terrain Database in order to properly identify terrain ahead. EGPWS depends on aircraft navigation system. According to aircraft location provided by navigation system, EGPWS identifies the potential terrain of the specific area. When an aircraft arrives at terrain proximity, an oral alert is given before 60 to 40 seconds of collision.
Terrain, terrain, terrain.
If aircraft approaches more near than before 30 to 20 seconds of terrain clearance, the warning is changed.
Terrain ahead, pull up. Terrain ahead, pull up.
Now, let us look at a crash which was caused due to failure of GPWS. 16th August 2015. Oxibol, Indonesia. Trigana Air flight number 267 was scheduled from Sentani to Oxibol. The aircraft was ATR-42-300 and was carrying 54 people on board. On approach to Oxibol Airport, Trigana Air flight number 267 suddenly vanishes. After search, tragic crash of Trigana Air 267 was confirmed with no survivors. The aircraft crashed at a mountain which was 15 miles away from airport. All 54 people on board lose their lives. On investigation, they found that cockpit crew had disabled GPWS on a flight prior to the crash, but they forgot to enable it on crash flight. While aircraft was making approach to Oxibol Airport, visibility was dropping with thick cloud forming near the mountain. Due to thick cloud, pilots were not able to identify train ahead them, and as GPWS was disabled, it didn't provide any warning. At last, aircraft ended up colliding with mountain. Here, a major question arises regarding cockpit crew disabling very vital system, that is GPWS. Investigator talked with other pilot flying in the same area. They found that it was common practice among pilot to disable GPWS while landing. Because the terrain around that area is not properly updated in World Terrain Database, due to which GPWS provide false warning. Another reason for the crash was pilot overconfidence, as they have made multiple approach to Oxibol Airport. They were familiar with the surrounding, because of which they made straight approach to Oxibol Airport, which was not mentioned in approach chart. Investigation concluded that pilot error was the main reason of crash. Investigator has also suggested Indonesian Civil Aviation Authority to update proper terrain altitude on World Terrain Database. If pilot would not have disabled GPWS, this crash could have been prevented. This crash shows the importance of GPWS while flying in low visibility. That is all for this video. Thank you everyone for your valuable time. Hope the video might have been informative to you. If you have come this far, then please like and share the video. And if you like the content of the channel, then please subscribe to it. Don't forget to hit the bell icon so that you can get all the updates regarding our upcoming videos. You can follow us on social media as well. Link for all the social media account will be given in description down below. Until next time, stay home, stay safe. Thank you.